it in your career, in your 35-year career, you've handled hundreds, if not thousands, of cases. What case in your mind is the most memorable and why?
Very interesting question, Cindy, because as you might suspect, I've handled a lot of cases during my time. But probably the case that sticks with me the most is the case of a young African woman who visited America, came on a temporary visa, and it turns out that she was escaping torture and oppression in her home country. She applied to be able to stay in this country, and she was denied, and they were getting ready to deport her. And she came to me and asked me, could I help her? I litigated a case in front of what was then called the Immigration Service, arguing that her fate, if she returned to her country, was a bleak one. And surprisingly enough, I was able to convince the judge to grant her political asylum, and she is happily a citizen of the United States.
Over 35 years of practicing law, you've decided to become a judge. What criteria do you look for in a judicial candidate?
I believe that it's important that whoever wins this seat be an established member of the community. I've spent 15 years in this community working with various entities, including, but not limited to, the Flagler County Chamber of Commerce. I was a board member for 7 years. I was president of the Flagler County Bar Association for 5 years. I am a member of the Flagler Hospital Foundation. I was a board member for the PAL. I was counsel to the local NAACP. And I think those kind of things demonstrate my commitment to service to my community.
Sid, our community and the world has been going through some major changes these past few years. What do you feel a solution for mentoring our youth can be to guide them down the right path?
You know, Cindy, for every success I've had in life, I've also experienced failure. But the good news is that every time I was faced with one of those challenges of having to get back up, there was someone from either a generation or generations in front of me who were there to prop me up, talk to me, provide me guidance, coach and mentor me. And there's a real difference between coaching and mentoring. And I think both are very good things. But you coach people, you know, for a particular objective. You mentor people for life. And I had that. And I think that is what we need to do today between the various generations, not just between seniors and teenagers or seniors and pre-adolescents. I think all of the generations of our society, you know, need a happy meeting ground or a happy medium where they can meet and share ideas, share solutions, and share problems. It's only through communicating with each other generationally that I think we will be able to address and mitigate some of the challenges facing our society today.
As you know, there are 5 other candidates vying for this position. What should people know about you, about Sid Nowell, that distinguishes you from the other candidates?
Well, you're right. This is quite a horse race. It's like the Kentucky Derby. And while we all may be thoroughbreds, which I mean is that we all have practiced law, what distinguishes me from the rest of the group is my experience. Not only as a lawyer, but I have spent at least the last 10 years serving in the role as an arbitrator and a mediator. None of my other opponents can make that claim. And I think it's an important fact that my practice as an advocate, as a neutral, as a fact finder, is not only local in nature, but statewide and nationwide. And I think that breadth of my experience is what distinguishes me from my opponents.